Friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. Dhanesh here. In this video, I am going to discuss about additive theorem in probability. See, you know, probability, it is the ratio of number of favorable cases. Probability is equal to number of favorable cases divided by total number of equally likely cases. This is the classic definition of probability. These basic concepts you are familiar. Now I am going to discuss about one of the most important theorem in probability, that is additive theorem, and there is multiplication theorem that we will be covering in the next video. In this video, I am going to cover about additive theorem. Before starting with additive theorem, I want to discuss about this concept that is known as mutually exclusive. What is mutually exclusive, or we call it as disjoint? Both are same concepts, mutually exclusive or disjoint. Two events are mutually exclusive if they cannot occur at the same time. If they cannot occur at the same time, they are mutually exclusive or disjoint. That's all. Now we will get into the additive theorem. First, I am talking about the additive theorem for mutually exclusive events. Additive theorem for mutually exclusive events. So what would be the additive theorem for mutually exclusive events? The additive theorem states that if A and B are two mutually exclusive events, then the probability of either A or B is given by, very important, A or B. See, A or B, we will write it as A or B is equal to probability of A plus probability of B. A or B is A, this A union B, insert, we will use this, that is probability of A plus probability of B. This we call it as the union, in set also we know this. This is A or B, that is probability of A plus probability of B. The additive theorem states that if A and B are two mutually exclusive events, then only we can apply this. Then the probability of either A or B, probability of A or B is the sum, probability of A plus B. This is additive theorem. And again, we can extend this theorem to more events. It's like even you can write probability of A union B union C is equal to probability of A plus probability of B. It's really simple. It is probability of C. This is the additive theorem. So I am giving you a simple example to understand this concept, then it would be easy for you. The first question, you can see the first question. This is the first question. It's given here. A card is drawn from a pack of 52. What is the probability that is king or queen? This is the question. A card is drawn from a pack of 52. What is the probability of that it is king or queen? It is both the events, whether it is king or queen, it is mutually exclusive events. So we can apply this theorem, whatever we discussed. See, so we are going to discuss that. Let's see this. The probability, let us assume that the probability of A, let event A, that is, draw a card of king. Event A, we are taking it as draw a card of king. Event B, we are taking it as drawing a card, draw a card of Qin. So let A and B we assume like that. Then probability of the card. Card is king or queen is, it is probability of card is king plus probability of card is queen. So the king we have taken it as A and queen it is B. Then you can write it as probability of A, we can write it as probability of A union B is equal to probability of A plus probability of B, that is equal to 4 by 52, because the total number of cards is 52. You know, in a, you know, pack of cards there are total 52 cards, and the king, it is, you know, four kings are there, so 4 out of 52 plus again 4 by 52 for queen as well. This is equal to 1 by 13 plus 1 by 13. This is equal to 2 by 13. This is about the additive theorem for mutually exclusive events. But what about for non-mutually exclusive events? If the events are not mutually exclusive, not mutually exclusive means two events, they occur at the same time. See, if they cannot occur at the same time means they are mutually exclusive. If they occur at the same time, they are not mutually exclusive. So next we are going to discuss about additive theorem for non-mutually exclusive events. For non-mutually exclusive events. Once again, two events are mutually exclusive if they cannot occur at the same time. If they are occurring at the same time, they are non-mutually exclusive events. Then we need to write the probability of A or B is probability of A or B is equal to the first equation for non-mutually exclusive events, probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A and B. That means probability of A union B, or means union, it is equal to probability of A plus probability of B minus A and B means A intersection B. That is A and B. And means intersection, or means union. That's the way you need to understand. Again, probability of A union B, this you can write it as probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of AB. Intersection means you can multiply. So this is the additive theorem for non-mutually exclusive events. Again, I am giving you a question. You can, you know, again understand it clearly. This is the question. The second question. A shooter is known to hit a target 3 out of 7 shots. Another shooter is known to hit the target 2 out of 5 shots. Find the probability of the target being hit at all when both of them try. So this is the question. A shooter is known to hit a target 3 out of 7 shots. Another shooter is known to hit the target 2 out of 5 shots. Find the probability of the target being hit at all when both of them try. So let's solve this question. See, the probability of the first shooter hitting the target, we are taking it as PA. Let us take it is PA. PA is equal to 3 by 7. The probability of the second shooter, we are taking it as PB. Probability of the second shooter, it is equal to 2 by 5. Because it's given in the question, another shooter is known to hit the target 2 out of 5 shots. Event A and B are not mutually exclusive. They are asking, find the probability of the target being hit at all when both of them try. So they are not mutually exclusive. They are happening at the same time. So probability of A union B is equal to probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A intersection B, that is equal to 3 by 7 plus 2 by 5 minus 3 by 7 into 2 by 5. That is equal to, you can write it as 29 by 35 minus 6 by 35. This is equal to 23 by 35. So that's all today. So in the next video, we will be covering, you know, the concept like what would be the multiplication theorem for, you know, mutually exclusive events and non-mutually exclusive events. We covered most of the deep learning, most of the supervised machine learning algorithms, gradient descent, backpropagation, neural networks, statistics, then probability, math concept. See, a lot of things it's covered in the playlist. I will be given in the link for the description, in the link in the description of this video. Please watch and please subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching.